I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, a Microsoft employee on the Forms team, and today I'm going to look at inserting images and videos into Forms. So creating your forms and quizzes is not just about the questions and the answers, but also about video and images. You want to be able to enrich your forms with a lot of content. And so this is what we're going to take a look at today. So I'm going to start by going to my trusty desktop. I'm going to open the Microsoft Forms website, and we're going to get started. I have a few prepared images that I'm going to use throughout this demo, and I have a video that's pre-uploaded on YouTube, and I have large images of various sizes to play with. So I'm going to start by creating a new form, and let's call it the cube form. Cube form. And I'm going to turn off the suggestions, and I'm going to ask for a number. So let's see, require, I'm going to have a restriction here. I want a number as the answer. And the question is going to be how many cubes do you see? And of course, this is going to be a question related to an image I will upload. So in the form here, if you click on the question to edit it, there's a little icon of an image with a pen, and it is insert, paste, or drag media. So I can click on this, and then I will be prompted to insert an image or a video. So I'm going to do image. And in this case, I have three options. I can Bing search for an image online. And so I can type in a search term here, and it will give me a list of images that it finds for that search term. One thing I can do is specify whether I only want to search for images that are license free or have more liberal licenses, or all images. I can also take a look at my OneDrive. I currently don't have any images in my OneDrive, but if I did, I could click and select that, or I can click upload and upload an image that I have on my desktop. So I am going to pick this image here, and it is a picture of a bunch of form cubicles or cubes, and the image is quite large, so it takes a little bit of time to load here. And then once it loads, I will see it in this form right here. See if it's not loading correctly. I'll delete it and try again. Add text. Insert image. Upload image. See if this works. Ah, perfect, it works now. Okay, how many cubes do you see? Cubes with an S. Perfect. And enter your answer. And I will limit it again, restriction to a number. Perfect. Okay, so now I can preview this, and you'll see that question number one, and I can type in a value here, and I see the picture. Now, another thing I can do is, when I go back to the editor, I can click on the image and select a little pencil, and I can kind of pick. First of all, I can zoom into the image. So let's try that. So I'm going to zoom into the picture. And then if you go in preview, you see the image is zoomed in. So you lose kind of the border of the image when you do that. But that's okay. In some cases, that's what you want. And I'm going to, and also, by the way, you can move the image. Let's see. Can I move it? Edit. There he goes. I can move the image. So not only can I zoom into it, but I can select the portion I want. And then preview, and you'll see only the portion of the picture you want. So that's kind of cool. Okay, now another thing I'm going to do is edit, and I'm going to select full width here, and I'm going to zoom out, and there we go. So that's the full picture, sort of how I intended to do it in this form. Okay, so that's good. And if you click on preview, you see the full picture and you can count how many cubes and enter the value right here. Okay, another thing I wanna do is just take a look at alternative text here for screen readers. Now, this is always neglected, but for people who cannot quite, either visually impaired or so on, they can't quite view the picture for whatever reason, it's really nice to have an alternative text here. So for example, image with many Microsoft Forms cubes. Now, of course, in this case, it wouldn't help you answer the question, but it would guide you as to see what this image is. Okay, so this is very nice, and I can preview this. Okay, now what I want to also do is just take a look quickly at what other picture formats would look like in here. So I'm going to upload an image. But this time I'm going to upload a really small image. Now this is a tiny, like, you know, 30 pixel wide image. And so you can see that it's been kind of zoomed in to fill this space. And so you probably don't want to do this. And then if you put it full screen, you'll see that it fills in the entire question here. But because the resolution of the image is so low, it just looks terrible. So you probably don't want to, you want to pick images that have a fairly sizable size in order to view them correctly. So what I've done is I'm going to take a look at another image here. But this is an image, the first image, but rotated 90 degrees. And so now it's rotated up and down like that. And then if I zoom it in or put it to full size, you'll see that it can only fill this screen here, this portion here. And so we can kind of screen capture that. I'm going to go into MS Paint. I'm going to paste my screen. And I'm just going to tell you what the resolution roughly of the image should be at the minimum. So we can crop that. And it's about 750 by 420 or something like that. So if you have an image that's 750 by 420, it's probably the ideal resolution or the minimum resolution to fill this, this rectangle here. What I'm going to do now is remove this again. And yeah, obviously if you put an image that's the right resolution, it will fill correctly. Now, I want to take a look at insert video. Now, unless you're in the corporate version where you can use Microsoft Stream to insert videos here, on the public version of the site, you can only use YouTube URIs here. So what you can do is upload a video to YouTube. You have to make it, obviously if it's private, you won't be able to paste the URI here and have people view it. But as long as it's unlisted or public, then the URI will work. So I'm going to cut and paste a URI of a video I have and click add. And this is a video of little Microsoft Form blocks that are falling down here on a table. And here we go. It's actually just 11 seconds long, and we are done. So now I can take a look at preview, and this is what my my form looks like. And of course, you can take a look at the video and answer the question. The nice thing is you can have one video for each questions, or you can have, you know, one video and then multiple questions at the bottom. So it's really up to you to kind of customize this the way you want it. Okay, so that kind of makes sense. Basically, you, instead of sharing the link to a video, you can share the link to a form that has a video in it. And that will allow you to not only have the person see the video, and by the way, the person can still, you know, go full screen here or, you know, do the adjustments on the YouTube video player. So you can still see it full screen, but the benefit of sending a form link with the video in it instead of just a video is that now you have control over kind kind of the questions you want to ask and feedback and so on. Okay, one more thing I want to do, and that is styling with images. So I'm going to click on style. And normally there's a whole bunch of styles here, including some that are animated. But what you can do is you can click on the plus size to customize the theme, and you can customize it with a color or a image. So I'm going to click on image, upload, and I'm going to upload my cubes image that I had before. And here we go. Now I'm going to go back, and you're going to see that I'm going to actually remove this video just for I'm going to click on the question and remove it just to remove the distraction here. Okay, so this would be our questions, and then we have this background with the cubes in the back, but I can pick one of these themes here, and the first six themes kind of use the picture that I uploaded as part of the theme. So there's theme number one with the blocks in the back, this number two, this one is like somewhat in the forefront. Then there's this one where it's in the front here. Then this one, really nice. Actually, you can see the cubes very well with the text on top of it, with a styling on it so you can read the text. Here, this one, you have the cubes in the forefront and in the back. And then this one, you have the cubes kind of in the back. I kind of like this one the best in this case because the picture is so visible. Anyway, then you can click preview and you can see what it looks like. There we go. Or I can select another one, click preview. And you know, when you start the questions, you see the question with the cubes in the back and so on. So a lot to explore with here, but basically you can insert images on your forms questions. You can insert videos on individual questions that you have, and you can use images as your styling. So hopefully that gives you a bunch of ideas for how you style your forms. Thank you very much. Have a great day.